I'm Chris Bloch. I'm currently the chair of the Department of Biological Sciences at Bridgewater State University. So if students have administrative needs, for example, if you need a form signed, I'm usually going to be the first point of contact on that. In addition to my administrative responsibilities, I also teach a variety of courses, including Biology 122, which is the second semester of our general biology sequence for majors. General Ecology, which emphasizes the interactions between organisms and between them and their physical environment. And Biometry, which is a course in experimental design and statistical analysis for biologists. And finally, I teach a couple of upper-level ecology electives, Population Ecology and Community Ecology. As a researcher, I'm an ecologist, primarily working at the population and community levels of organization. Broadly, in general terms, what this means is that I'm interested in the factors that determine the abundance and diversity of species. More specifically, I've spent most of my career studying the effects of large-scale disturbance events. For example, I spent most of the early part of my career studying the long-term responses of snail populations to hurricane disturbance in a montane rainforest in Puerto Rico. And I even had the opportunity to get some BSU students involved in this work. Only one of them ever dropped a tree on my head. I never really thought of myself as just the snail guy. I don't like to limit myself to one particular study organism, but rather I like to focus on the ecological question of interest and choose the best study organism to answer it. So as a result, my students and I have worked with a variety of different organisms, including mammals, arthropods, earthworms, and turtles. Our current focus is primarily on the biology of the Asian shore crab. This is an invasive species. It was introduced to the U.S. in the 1980s. Since then, its population has grown very rapidly. It's spread really quickly. And so now it is the dominant crab species in most rocky intertidal habitats in much of New England and the mid-Atlantic. So what we're really interested in is how its population size has changed over time, and most importantly, how its impacts on other species have changed over time, and what are the factors that drive these changes. Most of our work is field-based, which is cool because it involves going to the beach. But we also do some lab work as well, and we do our best to try to incorporate both experimental and observational approaches. If you're interested in learning more about what I do, feel free to stop by my office, or better yet, send me an email to arrange a meeting time. I'm happy to discuss any of this in greater detail. Thanks for listening.